It's the day before Christmas. Make the Christmas catch you in a good mood. Welcome to this Tuesday edition of Jamaica Magazine. I'm your host, Adrian Atkinson. Today, we come to you from the beautiful Spanish Court Hotel right here in Kingston. Coming up on our program today, we explore the true meaning of Christmas and hear some of your plans for the holidays. We also bring to a close our time with our special friend from the Salvation Army for this season. All this and so much more right after this break. Please stay with us.
Good day, I'm Andrea Chisholm, and this is your GIS News for Tuesday, December 24. Government pensioners are set for an increase retroactive to July 2013. Information Minister Senator Sandria Faulkner says Cabinet recently approved the increase for pensioners, including spouses and dependents of deceased officers.
The increases range from $1,280 to $2,650. Widows and widowers will receive an increase of $1,620 per month and dependents $1,750 monthly.
Senator Faulkner says $500 million has been approved to cover the increase, which was provided for in the 2013-2014 budget. Stopover arrivals out of the United Kingdom have increased, reversing 5 years of negative growth. Tourism Minister Dr. Wicca McNeil says that is a major success attributable to the hosting of the Jamaica House Initiative in London during the 2012 Olympics. He says the benefits being seen now affirm the value in the government's decision to stage the initiative.
All our tour or travel partners had come to Jamaica House, and even in Jamaica House we were able to finalize some deals and have discussions which we felt would have far-reaching effects. This year is the first year now we're showing positive growth, and strong positive growth of 4.6%.
National Security Minister Peter Bunting says the DNA bill designed to assist crime fighting will be ready for tabling in the Parliament in January 2014. While speaking at a recent Jamaica House press briefing, Minister Bunting cautioned that the DNA legislation would not by itself be the ultimate solution to solving crimes.
What it is going to facilitate is the compulsory collection of DNA samples from suspects and the maintenance of a database of these samples and the profiles that they get from the samples. That is really going to become very valuable after you've built a database that you can compare the samples you may recover from a crime scene.
The National Security Minister says the administration is moving quickly to bring the legislation, which was first mooted in 2006, into force. This, along with a number of other key pieces of legislation, is significant in the fight against crime. Meanwhile, the Jamaica Constabulary Force, JCF, has received 89 new vehicles to add to its fleet. 72 vehicles came from the Ministry of National Security, 15 from the Tourism Enhancement Fund, and 2 specialized vehicles were donated by the National Road Operating and Constructing Company. The vehicles were handed over on Monday during a ceremony at the Office of the Police Commissioner. National Security Minister Peter Bunting says between 2012 and 2013, the JCF received 3 times the amount of vehicles than in 2010-2011. Turning to other security issues, he says the Major Organized Crime and Anti-Corruption Task Force, MOCA, has been relentless in its quest to take the profit out of crime.
We're seeing many white-collar criminals, many white-collar suspects now being arrested. And I can anticipate now that raids and arrests are taking place, not just in inner city communities, but now in uptown communities.
Jamaica is to benefit from a $20 million project aimed at determining the prevalence of tobacco-induced diseases. Health planners are expected to derive useful data from the international project dubbed Burden of Obstructive Lung Diseases, BOLD. Focus will be on chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD, one of the leading tobacco-induced conditions.
This particular project will give us a lot of information, put health plans in place in our health system, which will only improve the quality of health care.
The board project will be undertaken by the Ministry of Health in collaboration with the Pulmonary Research Group from the University of the West Indies Department of Medicine. It begins in March 2014 and is jointly funded by the National Health Fund and the UWI Principals Initiative Fund. And finally, the Anata Bay Hospital has received some well-needed equipment to improve its service delivery. The donations, inclusive of a blood pressure unit and suction machines, came from a number of corporate entities. They were presented to the facility recently as part of the Governor General's hospital tour.
During our tour, we want to cheer not just the patients, but the faithful and committed and dedicated workers who give of themselves every day and who are on the front line taking care of our nation.
And that's it for GIS News today. I'm Andrea Chisholm. Thank you for watching.
See, Marcia Osbande, ima one of the biggest joggies.
Wait, somebody has screamed.
Who them man there? How would them do the Jackie Lick data?
It's serious times. Speak up for justice and keep your eyes open. When you hear about any crime, report it. Silence brings violence.
A message from the Ministry of National Security.
Tomorrow we celebrate what is considered by many as the most wonderful time of the year. It's a special day for me too. But why is Christmas so special? Is it the gifts, the fun and frolic? Or the food. In our next feature, we explore the true meaning of Christmas.
For centuries, Christians all over the world have celebrated December 25 as Christmas Day. The day and the period immediately before and after December 25 is eagerly anticipated for the festivities commemorating the birth of Jesus Christ, who represents the salvation of mankind. Over the years since his birth, several traditions have emerged, but central to most of them is the act of giving, and an emphasis on togetherness as family and friends generally come together to celebrate the holidays. In Jamaica, Christmas is celebrated with great fanfare, starting with caroling in the morning, a fabulous feast accented by the traditional sorrel drink, and of course, the Christmas cake and pudding. And let's not forget the gifts and all the fancy decorations. But what does Christmas really mean to the man on the street?
Christmas to me is like basically family oriented. Just kicking back with your family. That's basically Christmas dinner and all of that.
Christmas to me is the remembrance or a reminder of our Savior coming. We should all remember that He was here. It's the reason why we can have a second chance.
The Savior was born on that day, which I think it is just appropriate that all of us should celebrate it.
The true meaning of Christmas is for giving and sharing and love for each other, you know. Care for the elder and the disabled.
That's a season of giving and accepting the Lord Himself as a Savior.
Administrative Bishop of the New Testament Church of God of Jamaica and the Cayman Islands, Wellesley Blair, believes that Christmas is a time of celebration as it represents the fulfillment of a promise.
Christmas to me is the coming into being of the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ, who was promised from the foundation of the world. In Genesis 3:15, when the Bible speaks that God says that the seed of the woman shall bruise the serpent's head, that was the first promise. And Christmas means joy, happiness, and love.
He believes as a result of the overindulgence and commercialization of Christmas, the true meaning sometimes gets overshadowed. He is, however, encouraging Christians to lead the way by remaining focused on the real reason for the joy and happiness at this time.
Christians ought not to be caught up in the commercialization of Christmas. They ought to portray the true meaning, which is to project Christ as love. You see, we have a little song that says, "Love came down at Christmas." And the true sanctified meaning of Christmas is love. John 3:16 speaks, "For God so loved the world that he gave." And then you know that Christmas is a time of giving and receiving. But we must also remember it is more blessed to give than to receive. So that's where your happiness comes in. When one gives and gives from the heart, he's happy. The terrible mistake that many people have been making over the years is to refer to it as Xmas. X means not. And Christ, take Christ out of Christmas, you have Mass. So without Christ in Christmas, there is nothing. So he is the reason for the season.
During the last 2 weeks leading up to Christmas Day, it is impossible to forget that Christmas is coming, as there is seemingly an all-out assault on your senses. Music is blaring, there are attractively decorated windows, the fascinating lights and the delicious seasonal smells assail your sensibilities on every street and in every store, beckoning you to buy more and more. Consumers are seduced into purchasing items that are so attractively packaged. They wander from store to store, intoxicated by everything in sight. But if you know that you have a limited budget, you are encouraged to shop wisely at this time.
Nutritious food, succulent dishes, superior workmanship, and excellent service. Jamaica is on the go. Let's grow what we eat and eat what we grow. Let's harness the indomitable spirit of our most valued resource, our people. Let's support our local businesses. After all, buying Jamaican means building Jamaica.
Over the holidays, it can get quite hectic with the children around. But be not dismayed, though. Here are some ways you can get your children engaged while enjoying the festivities.
Tis the season to be jolly. Oh yes, it's Christmas time again. For parents and caregivers, this season can be extremely hectic with the children on holiday, but there are ways you can get your kids involved. Almost everyone loves Christmas, especially children. They get a holiday from school and are free to indulge in succulent Christmas meals. Many look forward to singing Christmas carols and most of all receiving gifts on Christmas Day. But how can we keep them actively engaged during the holidays?
In our house, we try to make Christmas very special and fun and try to keep the kids from driving us crazy. We do baking, we bake cookies, we bake brownies.
Such activities not only keep the children engaged but aid in their overall development and create an environment to develop deeper friendships.
It gets them involved in being a part of Christmas and actually feeling responsible.
There are a number of cost-effective methods parents and caregivers can employ to ensure they get the young ones to participate in Christmas activities. So for those who have complained that money tight, try baking a potato pudding instead or a traditional Christmas cake. Also,
you can go for walks. If you're living in the country, you can take your children for walks and it's nice and cool in the Christmas. Talk about what's happening during Christmas. You don't need to have a traditional Christmas tree. You can get a nice like a ficus tree or whatever you can get, a palm tree or whatever. And one of the things that you can do is you don't need to buy Christmas decorations. You can actually make Christmas decorations, which is even more fun, and you interact with your kids. You can find little things around the house, little trinkets, little boxes and stuff.
So there are a number of things that can be done to ensure that each member of the family is engaged during the festive season. But let's focus some more on food preparation. Food is a major part of Christmas celebrations for many families, from breakfast on Christmas morning to dessert after the main meal. We caught up with some family and friends demonstrating one dish that could be used as part of your Christmas breakfast and one dessert. Today we have with us Santa Israel, Santa Raj and Santa Orion with the help of Auntie Donnet, who will be showing us a simple meal and snack to prepare just for the festive season.
Hi, I'm doing saltfish flippers, which you need saltfish of course, and you need onion, thyme, and scallion. And you need flour, black pepper, salt, and oil.
Auntie Donnet got to quickly cooking with the little Santas, who were excited to share in the cooking process. Israel was indeed a little chef who knew his way around the kitchen, and his knife skills were quite sharp. Careful supervision, however, was provided by Auntie Donnet, so parents do take note. After mixing the batter for the fritters, the kids, ably guided, turned on the stove and got to frying.
Right now, that's two scoops, that's two saltfish fritters.
Right.
The more you put in there, the more saltfish fritters you're going to get.
These little things are the things what make the saltfish fritters taste nice.
So who said that boys didn't like the kitchen? This Christmas, encourage them, like our little Santas, to take part in the cooking.
We tend to domesticate the girls alone and leave out the boys. It's important to bring your boys into the kitchen also, so that they can become more independent and so that they can take care of themselves and not have to depend on anybody too.
Boys, hope you heard that. When we come back, we'll see how the fritters turned out and watch our little Santas bake Christmas cookies. So come.
I'm Orion.
I'm Raj.
I'm Israel.
And you're watching School Zone. Happy holidays.
Auntie Donnet and the children did well with the saltfish fritters. See the outcome. Good job, guys. Now, cookies are a favorite snack for children throughout the year and also make for a great dessert or snack during the festive season.
We are going to be doing cookies. It's pre-packaged. You can get it in the supermarket. First, what we're going to do is, come on, guys. We're going to do the eggs. We're going to have Raj beat the eggs. We're going to beat it like this.
Then you know, you're going to beat it that way, you get out.
Right. Then we're going to have Orion pour the egg in. Just pour it in. We're going to grease the tin with some butter. We're going to use a hand towel to get a little bit of butter. And then we're going to rub it. Come, we're going to have Raj rub it. Rub it in. Rub it all over the thing. Get it everywhere.
A cookie cutter was then used to make festive shapes such as Christmas trees from the dough. This is a fun way to incorporate the Christmas celebrations, and children love making these cool designs.
These cookies right here are going to bake for 20 minutes. And then we're going to take them out the oven and put in these.
And after 20 minutes, voila!
These were our chocolate chip cookies. I hope you can try them at home.
Now you see, you don't need a lot of money to engage your children this Christmas. Cook with them, decorate with them, and more importantly, use these opportunities to bond with them. Happy holidays.
Triumph and come ye, oh come ye too.
Manufacturers urged to export items to Venezuela to offset Jamaica's oil debt. 48 housing solutions for residents of Majesty Gardens. Jamaica-China Human Development Program bearing fruit. And Christmas comes alive for senior citizens and staff at the Office of the Prime Minister. You're watching Jamaica House Weekly. I'm Andrea Chisholm. Prime Minister Portia Simpson Miller has urged manufacturers to utilize the opportunity to get more Jamaican products into the Venezuelan market by participating in a trade compensation agreement under the Petrocaribe deal. The move would assist the country in clearing its $2.5 billion oil debt with a South American country. Carib Cement became the first company to tap into the arrangement when the first batch of 20,000 tons of clinker was loaded onto this vessel last Thursday en route to Venezuela. From now until April 2014, 100,000 tons valued at $8.5 million will be shipped.
I would like to urge other Jamaican manufacturers to access this trade compensation mechanism so that more Jamaican goods and services will enter the Venezuelan market.
And prior to the function, the Prime Minister joined Minister of Science, Technology, Energy and Mining, Philip Paulwell, in Caracas, Venezuela, for the Petrocaribe Heads of Government meeting. The Prime Minister insisted that her participation in meetings of this nature and other official international assignments are done to bring tremendous benefit to Jamaica.
I will never say no to any country that I know Jamaica and the people of Jamaica will benefit from a visit to those countries. To those officials.
Mrs. Simpson Miller pointed to her recent visit to China, from which she said Jamaica gained tangible results.
I came back with 1.6 billion Jamaican, not alone a grant to the government and people of Jamaica.
And the Prime Minister has again fulfilled a promise to offer housing solutions to persons in the inner city. The first 48 houses under the revamped inner city housing program were handed over to residents of Majesty Gardens on Wednesday. Mrs. Simpson Miller encouraged the recipients to keep their homes and community clean.
Let Majesty Gardens be a model of inner city development. You can do it, and I'm expecting you to do it, and I know you can. Do it for your children. Do it for yourself.
The residents have since renamed the National Housing Trust development Portia Simpson Miller Meadows. Phase 1 of the development, which consisted of 16 3-bedroom and 32 2-bedroom apartment units, cost approximately $172 million.
I particularly wish to thank you and your government for making possible the various study tours and exchanges which have taken place during this year.
Information Minister Senator Sandra Faulkner expressing gratitude to the Chinese government and mission for the human development program between both countries. Since the start of the year, more than 100 Jamaicans have benefited from the program in a number of areas, including agriculture, investment, industry, and energy. On Thursday, Senator Faulkner participated in a symposium with participants of the Chinese Human Resource Development Cooperation.
It is a useful means of gauging beneficiary experience, which I'm sure will provide the mission and the Chinese government with information to accurately plan for future exchanges.
Jamaica and China established diplomatic relations in 1972. As Jamaicans continue to bask in the euphoria created by local artist Tassan Chin, the Prime Minister congratulated the vocal powerhouse on winning last Tuesday's finale of American talent show The Voice. Describing her as an ambassador, Mrs. Simpson Miller said Tassan had joined the ranks of a long list of outstanding Jamaican achievers. She also thanked Jamaicans at home and in the diaspora for helping Chin win the competition and said a larger celebration was appropriate. A festive mood and light moment with the Prime Minister as she spread some good cheer to senior citizens at a treat at Vale Royal. While thanking them for paving the way for the younger generation, the Prime Minister feted them with gifts.
As we look to the celebration, of the birth of our Master, I felt that it was important that we give our seniors, some of our seniors, particularly those in homes, to share a few moments with us here at Vale Royal.
Here, here, here.
And Mrs. Simpson-Miller also reached out to the staff of the Office of the Prime Minister during a function on Friday.
I wish for all of you and members of your family a peaceful and restful Christmas. And I pray that for next year, you will all reap success, not only for yourselves, but for members of your family.
And that's it for this week's edition of Jamaica House Weekly. Join us next week for the latest from the Office of the Prime Minister.
I know that you've been collecting for the past few weeks.
Yes.
Tell us how that has been going and what would you like to say to the rest of Jamaica as we wrap up our Tuesdays with you for this year?
Well, what I would really want to say that despite the fact that we're all facing the financial crisis and money is much more difficult to come by, the Jamaican folks have continued to give and give. It was quite slow in the first beginning when we launched the kettles on the 8th of November. But as a count as of today, we have been doing quite well, and we are looking forward to reach our target. And let me say thanks to all Jamaica for their contribution this year, and we look forward to continued serving those who are in need in the coming year, and may God bless each and every one of you.
For Christmas Day, I'll be spending Christmas with my family, eating, and then we'll go back to work.
Going country, I'll spend it with my family.
My plan for the holidays is basically stay home with my mom and relax and cook.
Go to church.
I'll be at work, working straight through the holidays.
Go home and enjoy myself with my family.
That's our program for today. Thank you for watching. We'd like to say a special thank you to the Spanish Court Hotel, and we're going to be spending our Tuesdays with our special friends from the Salvation Army. Remember, to give to a worthy cause. We'd like to hear from you, so send an email to jamaicamagazine@jis.gov.jm. Please follow us on Twitter at JIS News and visit our website, jis.gov.jm. On behalf of the hardworking team here at the JIS, I'm Adrian Atkinson saying Merry Christmas when it comes.
This has been a production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.